This thing is permissible. Of course it's permissible. It's permissible to be optimistic. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لا تقول low, don't say low, ولكن يعجبني فعل. Don't say low, don't say only if I did this and if I did that, if I had planned it in this way. Because low, تفتح من الشيطان. Because when you say if, it opens up the doors to shaitan. Now a lot of people, they have a misunderstanding of this word, if. If here the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, don't question what's happened in the past. What's happened in the past, khalas, leave it. But you can use the word if to learn from. You can use the word if to talk about the future. Here, لا تقول لو إنها تفتع من الشيطان. Don't say low, because then you start regretting and start thinking that there's something wrong with your decision, etc. And then shaitan can open it. Just say قدر الله. That's it, خلاص. What's happened in the past has happened. I tried my best. I made a decision. And that's it. It's done. But if this is something that you can actually learn from, then that's a different situation. That's permissible. There's no disagreement between the ulama in that. If I woke up early, I would have come to the masjid earlier. So tomorrow I'm going to wake up earlier. If I studied hard, I would have passed the exam. All of these ifs about the past, and it could be if about the future. He says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I am alive, I will fast the 9th and the 10th. These kind of ifs are permissible because this person is still being optimistic. The if which is not allowed is where a person can open up the doors for shaitan to play with him and become pessimistic. Right. وَلَكِنْ يُعْجِمْنِي الْفَعْلِ. Then he says, what I like is a person is optimistic. Therefore, having positive, what do you call it? Having positive affirmations is something which is permissible and is asl. However, we've talked about this previously before in our durus, is that if there is something which is new that has not been addressed in the Kitab and the Sunnah, and it is not known to the A'imma from the Salaf, then you have to look at the origins of where this thing has come from. So for example, a person's got a tick on his clothing. You can wear a tick, of course. There's nothing wrong with a tick. You can wear an X. You can wear rainbow colours. However, what does it symbolise? Where is it coming from? What does it stand for? These things have to be taken into consideration. If this positive affirmation has come from ilm al-kalam, philosophy or other religions, then we will say using it in this manner is impermissible because of the entity of tashabbuh. من تشبه بقوم فهو منهم. Imitation. However, if a person is just doing it to say, okay, I'm going to be positive, so I'm going to wake up in the morning and say, yeah, I'm going to do this today, I'm going to do that today, I'm going to drag myself out, and I'm not going to go back to sleep, I'm not going to have extra naps and all of that kind of stuff, all of that is fine. So that's what I'd have to say as an answer, is that positive affirmations are permissible, except if it is coming from some kind of theory or ideology which is alien to Islam, then we will say that that's a form of imitation and it's not allowed in the manner that they are doing it in. That doesn't mean positive affirmations are impermissible. Just like rainbow, for example, these colors are permissible. Nobody can say that they're haram. But if you do it in the manner which represents something else, if you're wearing a tick, if it's done in a manner that represents the victory of goddess, oh, sorry, the goddess of victory, then obviously that takes a separate ruling. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.